Welcome to evening prayer. We're going to do compline tonight. I've got my lit candle with me. It reminds me that God is with us, light of the world. And even as the darkness closes in, his light shines forever. So to complete our day, let's pray. The Lord Almighty grant us a quiet night and a perfect end. Amen. Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. Just take a couple of moments to think about your day. What has been good? What has fed your heart? What has been hard and has starved your spirit? So I want to pray. Taking all of those things that we've thought about, and like holding them in our hands, the good and the bad, the difficult and the simple, and we just lift them up. Because if we carry them, it hurts us. We're not made to carry them. Cast all your burdens on him because he cares for you. That's what we're going to do now. We're going to use a word. If you have the words, if you can see them, they should be under notes. You can say with me, Most Merciful God, we confess to you before the whole company of heaven and one another that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. Forgive us our sins. Heal us by your Spirit and raise us to new life in Christ. Amen. O Lord, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. We're going to sing a song. We're going to sing at the King of My Heart. Sorry, too many verses off my heart.
Let the King of my heart be the mountain where I run, the fountain I drink from, woe is my song. Let the King of my heart be the shadow where I hide, and the ransom for my life, woe is my song. You are good. Good. Oh, you are good, good. Oh, you are good, good. Oh, oh, oh. You are good, good. Oh. Let the King.
Let's read a psalm together. We're going to read it quite slowly. Answer me when I call, O God of my righteousness. You set me at liberty when I was in trouble. Have mercy on me and hear my prayer. How long will you nobles dishonour my glory? How long will you love vain things and seek after falsehood? But know that the Lord has shown me his marvellous kindness. When I call upon the Lord, he will hear me. Stand in awe and sin not. Commune with your own heart upon your bed and be still. Offer the sacrifices of righteousness and put your trust in the Lord. There are many that say, who will show us any good? Lord, lift up the light of your countenance upon us. You have put gladness in my heart, more than when there are corn and wine and oil in. In peace, I will lie down and sleep. For it is you, Lord, only, who make me dwell in safety. That was Psalm number 4. And we're going to read from scripture, we're going to read from Jeremiah. Chapter 14 and verse 9. You, O Lord, are in the midst of us, and we are called by your name. Leave us not, O Lord our God. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. For you have redeemed me, Lord God of truth. I commend my spirit. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. Keep me as the apple of your eye. Hide me under the shadow of your wings. We're going to say the Nunc Dimittis, which is taken from Luke 2, 29 to 32. Save us, O Lord, while waking, and guard us while sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep may rest in peace. Now, Lord, let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people. A light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now and shall be forever. Amen. Save us, O Lord, while waking, and guard us while sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep may rest in peace. So let's pray. Father God, thank you for today, for all of the good that you have brought our way. For the food that we have eaten, for the sun that has shone, for the prayers that we have prayed and the songs that we have sung. Thank you that you woke us up this morning. And as we get ready to lie down and sleep, you fill us with your peace and with your loving kindness. And Father, as we get ready to sleep, we bring to you all that is troubling our hearts. Father, we pray for the world outside of coronavirus, for tensions between Iran and America, and tensions between China and Australia. India and Pakistan, for trouble in Iran, Iraq and Syria. For ongoing fights in Sudan and for terror in Niger and Nigeria. Pray, Father, for your peace and your protection, that you would strengthen your church, your body, with supernatural faith and boldness. Lord, in your mercy. Now, Father, we pray for areas where the church is not a legal group, for Korea and China, for Yemen, Saudi Arabia, for Jordan, Christians in Egypt, parts of India, parts of Pakistan. Father, thank you that even in the depths of misery, you reach in and you bring light. Father, thank you for these people living day by day, knowing your grace and your strength and your life. We pray healing for broken hearts and strength to keep living as your disciples. Thank you, Father, that you make such a difference to our lives, that you have done such a wonderful thing on the cross, that people live in danger knowing your grace, your faithfulness, and your love. They remind us who live in comfort that you are true and you are real and you are worth it. As you strengthen them, Father, would you quicken our hearts to hear your Spirit speaking to our country. Lord, in your mercy. And we, Father, we pray for those who are frightened in our country at this time. Those who don't know if they will still have a job. Those who are not sure where their next meal will come from. Those who have not seen the sun for 8 weeks. Those for whom this time is grievance and hard. Those who are struggling to cope. You are our Father. Fatherless. Father to the fatherless. Thank you that you're with everyone. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, because they will be satisfied. So we pray for those who are hungry that they would know your provision. And your grace and your love and your kindness. Help us, Father, to reach out and to see them. Don't let us be satisfied with what we have, but let us strive that you would be known. You would be known by our neighbours and our friends. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we pray for St. James as the government talks about opening the doors. We pray for our bishops as they make those difficult decisions. Bishop Pete and Bishop Sarah especially. Bishop Sarah comes from a nursing background and she knows what is safe. Father, give your leaders a heart for their people. Even more so they will not put anyone in danger. Father, thank you that we can trust our finances to you and our future to you, because you are big enough and strong enough to see us through. Give us wisdom as to what to do when. Lord, in your mercy, hear us. A couple of moments just to pray your prayers that you want to pray that I haven't. Praying for hospitals and care workers, nurses and doctors. You could pray for schools. You could pray for the government. visit this place, O Lord, we pray, and drive far from it the snares of the enemy. May your holy angels dwell with us and guard us in peace. And may your blessing be always upon us, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done. As we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. In peace we will lie down and sleep. For you alone, Lord, make us dwell in safety. Abide with us, Lord Jesus. For the night is at hand and the day is now past. As the night watch looks for the morning, so do we look for you, O Christ. The Lord bless us and watch over us. The Lord make his face shine upon us and be gracious to us. The Lord look kindly on us and give as you get ready to go and rest for the night. May you know God's comfort, his joy, and his peace.